After studying this module, you shall be able to know the need for setting standards, identify the different types of standards, learn the steps involved in setting standards, evaluate circumstances under which standards are revised, and understand the meaning of cost card. Let us know the need for setting standards. In the previous module, we have learned about meaning, nature, and significance of standard costing. Let us now learn about the concept of setting up of standards in this module. Let us first define a standard cost in order to know its meaning. The term standard has been called by different names in accounting. For example, a norm, a model, a yardstick, a benchmark, a criteria of excellence, etc. Therefore, a standard may be a norm or a measure of comparison in terms of specific items such as kilograms of material, labor hours or hours of plant capacity, etc. The Chartered Institute of Management Accountants, UK, defines standard cost as a predetermined cost which is calculated from management standards of efficient operations and the relevant necessary expenditure. It may be used as a basis for price fixing and for cost control through variance analysis. The term standard cost should not be confused with the term estimated cost. They are both different in following respects. Number one, estimated costs are very often less accurately determined. Standard costs are determined more realistically. 2. Estimated costs are developed from projections using average of past data, whereas standards are set more scientifically through the use of time and motion studies. 3. Estimated costs are not helpful to management, but standard costs provide basis for comparison to management. 4. The emphasis of estimated cost is on actual cost with which it is compared at the end of the period. Under standard costing, actual costs are ascertained only to facilitate their comparison with standard costs. Let us now learn about setting up of standards. The success of standard costing system will depend upon the setting up of proper standards. For the purpose of setting standards, a person or a committee should be given this job. In a big concern, a standard costing committee is formed for this purpose. The committee includes production manager, purchase manager, sales manager, personnel manager, chief engineer and cost accountant. The cost accountant acts as a coordinator of this committee. Normally, setting up of standards is based on past experience. The total standard cost includes direct material, direct labor, and overheads. Normally, all these are fixed to some extent. The standards should be set up in a systematic way so that they are used as a tool for cost control. We will now learn about various types of standards. On the basis of attainability of standards and frequency with which standards are revised, the standards are classified as ideal, normal, basic, current or expected actual standards. Each one is being discussed in brief as under. Number 1. Ideal or maximum efficiency or theoretic or perfect standards. These standards can be attained under most favorable conditions. The level of performance under ideal can be achieved through the best combination of most favorable price for material, labor, and maximum efficiency and capital utilization. They represent the ultimate goal for which any company strives for and attainment is not possible. 2. Normal standards. These are average standards that can be attained during a period of time which may be one complete business cycle. These are set on a normal capacity basis, which represents a volume that averages out the peaks and lows. 3. Basic standards. Basic standards remain unaltered for a long period of time and they are seldom revised or updated. They are usually revised when a whole business cycle is completed. 4. Attainable or expected actual standards. Current standards are those which are established for use over a short period of time and are related to current conditions. They represent current costs to be expected from efficient operations. Now let us learn about various elements and steps involved in setting up of standards. Various elements which influence the setting up of standards are set around various cost centers. According to J. Betty, a cost center is a department or part of a department or an item of equipment or machinery or a person or a group of persons in respect of which costs are accumulated and one where control can be exercised. Cost centers are necessary for determining the costs. If the whole factory is engaged in manufacturing a product, the factory will be a cost center. In fact, a cost center describes the product while cost is accumulated. Cost centers enable the determination of costs and fixation of responsibilities. A cost center relating to a person is called personnel cost center, and a cost center relating to all products and equipment is called impersonal cost center. Different elements or variables which influence the setting up of standards are material, labor, and overheads. These are being discussed one by one. Number 1. Setting up of standards for direct materials. There are several basic principles which ought to be appreciated in setting up of standards for direct materials. If material is used for a product, it is known as direct material. On the other hand, if the material cost cannot be assigned to the manufacturing of the product, it will be called as an indirect material. Therefore, it involves two things: quality of material and number 2, price of material. When the organization wishes to purchase material, the quality and size should be determined. The standard quality to be maintained should be decided. The quantity is determined by the production department. This department makes use of historical records, and an allowance for changing conditions will also be given for setting up of standards. A number of test runs may be undertaken on different days and under different situations, and an average of these results should be used for setting material quantity standards. The second step in determining direct material cost will be a decision about the standard price. Cost of material will be decided in consultation with purchase department. The cost of purchasing and storekeeping of materials should also be taken into consideration. The procedure for purchase of materials, minimum and maximum levels for various materials, discount policy, and means of transport, that is the carrying cost, are the other factors which have bearing on materials cost price. It includes the following: cost of material, ordering cost, and carrying cost. The purpose should be to increase efficiency in procuring and storekeeping of materials. The type of standard used, for example, ideal standard or expected standard, would also affect the choice of standard price. Number 2. Setting direct labor cost. If organization wishes to engage a labor force for manufacturing a product or a service for which some amount is to be paid, this amount is known as wages. If the labor is engaged directly to produce the product, this is known as direct labor. The second largest amount of cost is the labor cost. The benefit derived from the workers can be assigned to a particular product or a process. If the wages paid to workers cannot be directly assigned to a particular product, these will be known as indirect wages. The time required for producing a product will be ascertained and labor should be properly graded. Different grades of workers will be paid different rates of wages. The time spent by different grades of workers for manufacturing a product should also be studied for deciding upon direct labor cost. The setting of standards for direct labor will be done basically on following parameters. Number 1, standard labor time for producing a unit, and number 2, labor rate per hour. Standard labor time indicates the time taken by different categories of labor force, which are as under: skilled labor, semi-skilled labor, and unskilled labor. For setting standard time for labor force, previous experience, past performance records, test run result, work study, etc. are taken into consideration. The labor rate standard refers to the expected wage rates to be paid for different categories of workers. Past wage rates and demand and supply principle may not be a safe guide for determining standard labor rates. The anticipation of expected changes in the labor rate will be an essential factor in case there is an agreement with workers for payment of wages in the coming period. These rates should be used. If a premium or bonus scheme is in operation, then anticipated extra payment should also be included. Where a piece rate system is used, standard cost will be fixed per piece. The object of fixed standard labor time and labor rate is to devise maximum efficiency in the use of labor. 3. Setting standards for overheads. The next important element that comes under the head setting up of standards is overhead cost. The very purpose of setting standards for overheads is to minimize the total cost. Standard overhead rates are computed by dividing overhead expenses by direct labor hours or units produced. The standard overhead cost is obtained by multiplying standard overhead rate by the labor hours spent or number of units produced. The determination of overhead rate involves three things. Number 1, determination of overheads. Number 2, determination of labor hours or units manufactured. And C, calculating the overhead rates by dividing A by B. The overheads are classified into fixed overheads, variable overheads, and semi-variable overheads. The fixed overheads remain the same irrespective of level of production, while variable overheads change in proportion with the production. The expenses increase or decrease with the increase or decrease in output. Semi-variable overheads are neither fixed nor variable. These overheads increase with the increase in production, but the rate of increase will be much less than the rate of increase in production. The division of overheads into fixed, variable, and semi-variable categories will help in determining overhead cost. Let us now understand the method of setting up of standards. It is pertinent to note that a single standard set may not be suitable for all purposes and for all situations. Realistic and rational standards only help to take good decisions. These standards help in taking pricing and capital expenditure decisions which are critical to very survival of the company. Number 1. High standards. A high standard is helpful in cost reduction and motivating employees to try to reach that target. As high standards are not realistic, they are not helpful in product costing, inventory valuation, capital expenditure decisions, etc. The second type are low standards. A standard which is low or loose can be attained by poor performance. It defeats the very purpose of standard costing and fails to disclose inefficiencies. These standards are not helpful in cost control, as they are not accurate measures to compare actual results. The third one is current standards. A current standard is a standard which is established for use over a short period of time and is related to current conditions. It reflects the performance that should be attained during the current period. The period for current standard is normally 1 year. It is presumed that conditions of production will remain unchanged. In case there is any change in price or manufacturing condition, the standards are also revised. We will now learn about different circumstances under which standards are revised and meaning of standard cost card. Let us understand revision of standards concept. It is a difficult situation and decision for any organization to contemplate revision of standards. Some experts argue that frequent revision in standards would defeat the purpose of setting standards and will destroy the effectiveness. Conversely, other experts are also of the opinion that if the standards are not revised, they destroy the utility in inventory valuation and cost control. Therefore, the standards require a continuous review and frequent change at times. In this volatile world of fierce competition, changing technology, advent of multinational companies, new machineries, better quality of labor, increased awareness of labor in terms of their rights, etc. All these factors render the setting up of standards obsolete and unfit for use. Under these circumstances, if old standards are used, then it would result in poor cost control, unrealistic budgets, and unreasonable unit cost for inventory. Let us now discuss the circumstances under which standards are revised. For this, a company must make a plan or a program for revision of budgets so that standards can be set at a current attainable level. Hence, the following must be done for revision of standards. Number 1. Labor rate standard should be revised for any change in labor rates. 2. Material standards should be revised for any change in the types of material, quality of material or method of production. 3. If a new machine is purchased or replaced, then labor time standard, material quantity standards must be updated. 4. And lastly, in every company, there should be a system in force to revise standards at least every year. Therefore, a periodic review or revision is not only desirable but also necessary in order to accomplish the objectives of standard costing. For effective use of this technique, sometimes there is a need to revise the standards which follow for better control. Even standards are also subjected to change, like the production method, environment, raw materials and technology. Standards may need to be changed to accommodate changes in the organization or its environment. When there is a sudden change in economic circumstances, technology or production method, the standard cost will no longer be accurate. Standards that are out of date will not act as effective feed forward or feed control tool. They will not help us to predict the inputs required nor help us to evaluate the efficiency of a particular department. If standards are continually not being achieved and large deviations or variances from the standards are reported, they should be carefully reviewed. Also, changes in the physical productive capacity of the organization or in material prices and wages rates may indicate that standards need to be revised. In practice, changing standards frequently is an expensive operation and can cause confusion. For this reason, standard cost revisions are usually made only once in a year. Revision variances. We will now understand a concept briefly of revision variance. When a budget is revised, but the change discussed as above is not incorporated in the standard cost rate, a variance would arise, which is known as the revision variance. Revision variance is difference between basic standard cost and revised standard cost. We will now learn the meaning and concept of a cost card. After standards have been determined and set, they are tabulated in one statement to show the total standard cost per unit of output. As soon as standards are evolved, a master standard cost card is prepared and kept. The actual cost may be recorded in the job card, and subsequently the job card can be compared with standard cost card so that the variance could be worked out. A standard cost card contains an itemization of standard amount of materials, labor and overheads required to create one unit of a product. The card also multiplies the standard cost of each of these line items to arrive at a total standard cost of a product. The card has two purposes. Number one, to derive the standard cost of a product. Number two, to serve as the basis for variance analysis when actual costs of the product are compiled. The number of units and their standard cost that are listed on the card should be reviewed and possibly revised regularly. Due to all of the following factors, otherwise the standard cost card will gradually diverge from the actual results experienced when manufacturing a product. The standard cost card is comprised of the expected quantities of materials to be used during the production process, which can vary somewhat from the actual amounts used. For example, it may contain a certain amount of scrap that may be higher or lower than the actual amount experienced. Also, the amount of spoilage encountered during the setup of a production run may also vary from the standard amount listed in the standard cost card. The standard cost listed on the card may also vary from actual results. For example, there may be an expectation to purchase a component for 1000 rupees, but because it was actually purchased in small unit quantity than anticipated when the standard was created, the supplier charges a higher price per unit. The standard amount of labor stated on the card may be incorrect because of changes in workers' efficiency, altered equipment configurations, change in mix of experience levels used in production team, and so on and so forth. Similarly, the standard cost of labor stated on the card may be incorrect because of the changes in wages paid to employees, or in amount of overtime paid, or in the mix of employees used in the manufacturing process. The standard amount of overheads allocated to the product may also vary from actual results, since it is based on a combination of expected pool of overhead costs and an expected volume of production to be generated during the period. It is either estimate varies from actual results, then there will be a difference between standard overhead cost and actual overhead cost. A physical card is rarely used to store standard costs. Instead, this information is stored in the computer system and printed whenever it is needed. Let us recapitulate what we have learnt in this module. The term standard has been called by different names in accounting. For example, a norm, a model, a yardstick, a benchmark, a criteria of excellence, etc. Therefore, a standard may be a norm or a measure of comparison in terms of specific items such as kilograms of material, labor hours or hours of plant capacity, etc. The success of standard costing system will depend upon the setting up of proper standards. For this purpose of setting standards, one person or a committee should be given this job. On the basis of attainability of standards and frequency with which the standards are revised, the standards are classified as ideal, normal, basic, current, or expected actual standards. Different elements or variables which influence the setting up of standards are material, labor, and overheads. It is pertinent to note that a single standard set may not be suitable for all purposes and for all situations. Realistic, rational, and attainable standards not only help to take good decisions, but these standards help in taking pricing and capital expenditure decisions as well, which are critical to the very survival of organization. A company must make a plan or program for revision of budgets so that standards can be set at a current attainable level. Revision variance is the difference between basic standard cost and revised standard cost. And lastly, we will sum up by saying a standard cost card contains an itemization of the standard amount of material, labor, and overheads required to create one unit of a product. The card also multiplies the standard cost of each of these line items to arrive at the total standard cost of a product.